Hello friends, a very warm welcome once again to you on VStock. Yes friends, VStock is the one-stop favorite destination for CorelDraw tutorials on YouTube. In the very last time, this has become the one-stop favorite destination for CorelDraw tutorials, and it's your love and affection which actually pulls me and bring me here to present you a new brand new tutorial, a creative tutorial in CorelDraw of CorelDraw. So here I am, but this time we will act smartly, we will do some creative, but we'll do smartly. You may be thinking whether we were not actually acting or doing some things creatively, smartly or not, whether we are actually smart or not, we are creative or not. Yes, we are, we were using, but this time we will use the smart fill tool of the CorelDraw, which is inside the CorelDraw, and where you can find it in the toolbar of the CorelDraw, and here it is in the last, very last, the smart fill tool. For using smart fill tool, we have to create some object first. Today I have actually taken the A5 document, A5 size document, and this is of 148 of width and 210 point of height. These are 210 mm of height. So let's start creating something using the smart fill tool. Now take the rectangle, select the rectangle tool, take the rectangle, draw it, and make it the size of the document. It's the 148 of the width and 210 mm of this should be the 210 mm of height. Right. Press P to make it centrally aligned. Okay, this is the object. Let's start some more using the pen tool. You can draw something using the freehand to paint line, bezier tool, or whatever you want. You can, if you wish, you can use a 2-point line, and you can convert it, can modify it using then double clicking on the line and creating some nodes, etc. But today I am going to use the pen tool, one of my favorite drawing tool inside the CorelDraw. So let's start creating something. Okay, left click here and the first node, then click anywhere to create the another node. Keep your mouse pressed and drag your mouse and make your shape adjustable accordingly your requirement. Whatever my requirement it is here. Escape to come out from this object and then start a new object, a new curve. Okay, here it is. Again the same method repeating, but this time I am differentiating the curve. Escape to come out, create a new curve. As you are seeing, as I am creating, the curves are appearing here, rectangle which just we have created, we have actually drawn on the workspace area. Let's complete it. Okay, take the shape fill tool. If you think this is not a proper, this node is not properly according you, you can modify it. I am modifying it. double click to add a new note. I'm deleting it. Oh no, just undo. Okay, create a new. As many as object you can create it upon you. As you are seeing, as many as curve you want to, as you are seeing many curves I am actually created here, and modifying it as I want. You can modify it, you can create as per your requirement as you want. The good thing is, whatever you want to create, you can create easily inside this. So these are the curves objects which I created. Now, if you want to, if I say you to fill inside these objects, what you will do, you will just combine these two objects and then you have to, you know, close or join these separate objects, and then this task will get performed and will be labor extensive too. And in the today's time, no one wants to spend a lot of time on these type of activities. That's why CorelDRAW Smart Fill Tool is here. Now, here is a Smart Fill Tool. The objects have been created. Take the Smart Fill Tool. But before using this tool, let's actually understand the options of it. Here is a Fill Options. Here, you can specify it also. Here is a use default specify no fill. Means if you will click, the use default will actually default color will be filled inside this. Specify means the color which you will specify will get filled. Select the specify from the fills option. Choose a color of your choice. I have actually chosen the blue color. Now, how actually Smart Fill Tool works? It actually works so smartly that we don't understand actually what is happening so quickly. Just place the cursor of your mouse inside these two objects. Now, having specified the blue color, by just pressing the left button of the mouse. Oh, what is happening? The blue color is filled inside that. And new blue curve is created. The blue curve is separate object. This doesn't actually have disturbed these curves. Yeah, beautifully it actually created. It smartly created a new object. You need not to actually create or combined the two lines or two curves to make a new object. It's the work of the smart tool. Now the smart tool worked actually. Now come to the smart fill tool again. This time you can specify the color of your choice, and this time you can specify a new color also. Let's choose the yellow color. Okay, new curve is created. Again, again, and again. Yes, but you can want to use the color of your choice. Select the object and then apply whatever color you want. If you select and then select the color from the tool palettes, from the color palettes you can change, you can fill the colors of your choice. If you want to delete these objects by which you started actually drawn the images, you can, and you can actually disable the outline. So these are actually the objects which actually you actually wanted. Can give any color. If you want to make these colors of the same family, you can easily do. But you have to do, you just need to select the whole objects, whole curved objects of different colored filling, then click on the color you want to make of the sim family. If I'm using here the orange, or take the red. Now the red color is here. Select this object. The red color is appear here. The filled color, the last one filled, always available, always comes here. So now what you have to do, just click the left button of your mouse and remain it pressed. The all the similar shades of the red will get appear. Just choose one by releasing the left button of your mouse. You can choose very easily. Here it is, nearby shade of this. There it is. You can make a copy of it and use it in some other way also. So here it is. So friends, this was the tutorial of the smart fill tool inside the coreldraw. If you like the tutorial, please do a subscribe for VStock channel on YouTube, and please share and comment whatever you want. Now you are tutorial host Naveen Malik signing off now. Bye bye. We will meet you once again very soon.